she was maybe finished last season. I think it feels like I've been on for a long, long time. So, grinding away, getting ready to go as hard as I possibly can. Our team did a great job doing the same thing. So, we're excited. I'm ready to go.
Does it feel like you're finding your life again?
Yeah, I mean, I think all along we knew this was going to happen. It's just a matter of what day. And now I think we're pretty close. Until they actually say it's done, we need to be prepared. We need to take the steps as a quarterback and for our team. So we think that's a good point to start up here shortly, but we're envisioning it.
If you're in the magazine, I think James Harrison wants to put you up amongst Gerard Goodell and Sam Roethlisberger, a couple of guys, you know, if you've seen them. Just your thoughts on maybe them, since it's pretty hard stuff to have something to
do. I didn't see the article. Tell me what he said.
He basically said the Super Bowl and then two picks. He said the Super Bowl, the picks, the one. The opposing side of the field, he should stop trying to be like the man. He knows who he is. He knows exactly.
Well, I think it's not my place to comment on.
If things resolve here quickly, are you expecting any lasting effects from players in terms of play? Will fans notice any differences in players and play just because of the time off?
Well, I think a big component of why we did a lot of our off-season workouts and we pushed the envelope a little bit with the intensity of it was because if you're not playing football, it's hard to be in football shape. And it's going to be hard enough without pads and anything on to come right out and just start going 100%. So we talked and told the guys we needed to push yourself to be in a position that when you show up, you know, this isn't going to be a brand new thing that you haven't done in 6 months. Hamstrings, just look at guys who hold out and train. All of a sudden they come back and now they're expected to run 100 miles an hour, 12 straight plays. They can do it for one, two. If you haven't gone through camp, if you haven't done the things that you need to put your body in, then you're not going to have that same capacity, I guess, to absorb it when it comes about. That's why I think it was important to do some of the things that we did this offseason. Hopefully that will allow us to go into camp preseason and be where we need to be.
So you might tell us about how responsive your teammates were when you and him and a couple other guys were, let's get together and have these workouts. What about the guys kind of following that lead, the fact that you guys, let's get this together, the way some of the people responded, showed up, and generally at the production
room? I think the biggest thing, you know, from my perspective, is I needed each of the individual group leader to buy in. I think we needed Jason Witten, tight end. We also needed Mark Colombo to the offensive line. We needed Miles Austin. We needed these guys to be there. You need Terrence Newman, DeMarcus, J-Rep. If they're going to be there, their group will follow that group. Because that's, you know, each group looks up to their guy at that position. So, you know, I met with those players. We talked about it. I told them, you know, if you guys aren't committed to this, if you're going to be sporadic in nature about showing up, then this thing isn't going to be to anyone's benefit. To their credit, you know, the leaders of our football team, they came out there, they were working hard every day, and they were there every day. And there, it's hard for the second, third, fourth, and fifth guy not to. And made it easy to go. And if you didn't want to be part of it, you just moved on and went right along with what we were doing. The guys showed up and it was there. They put a lot of effort into it. If you go talk to Witt and some of those guys, might have been a little more than they wanted to at some points. But when I say that, it's a testament to how hard they work. You know, a guy like Jason works his butt off every day. So when he gets out on the field, he's not going to do anything but that. Just a trickle-down effect for everybody else.
Tony, there were a lot of angry words in the offseason throughout the labor thing. The writers kind of cooled in the last month or so. Do you think there will be any sort of residual residue, or are owners and players going to start acting like partners again? And just
well, I think there's always, predominantly, I don't know that there's a buddy-buddy relationship between owners and a lot of the players anyway. It's not as if, you know, everyone understands it's a business and they're your boss. So there's always that little bit hanging there. The other part of it is they also, these owners don't get to where they're at without understanding the business side of the ordeal. I would suspect that there won't be any hard feelings or ill will toward each other. I think everyone kind of understands when you're playing basketball and you're in a game and you, you know, talk trash to somebody else and blah, blah, you can also afterward go get a drink together and know that it wasn't, you know, anything meant personal life. So I think that's going to be exactly the same case. People say things, they do stuff, and then when it gets solved, you know that it's just part of that process.
Hey, real quick, with so many rookies coming in on short notice, any thoughts on maybe how quickly they can kind of get into it, or any advice, you know, insight you can take on these guys who only had a month or 6 weeks to learn a scheme?
Yeah. Well, it's not going to be easy. I think the number one thing is you have to be committed. I mean, you have to actually work at it. If you think that you can just, a lot of times when you're young, it can be the repetition that teaches you. Because as you go through a rep, you get another rep, you get five. In your first rounder, you're always involved in the play, so you kind of learn through repetitions. That won't be the case this year. It's going to be, you're going to have to teach yourself at night when you're sitting in your dorm room or wherever you're at, hotel room. You're going to have to step in. You're going to have to get in it. You're going to have to teach yourself. Go over it. What would I do if it blah, blah, blah? Wrong. I'm going to do it again. And I think the kids who are bright and intelligent and pick things up quickly will have an edge.
Tony, when you hear the running, when you hear, especially in Dallas news about, you know, Dez is doing this, Roy Williams and the wedding fiasco, this and that, do you as a leader kind of, do you put those guys on the side and just say, hey, you know, we don't need this right now, or do you just let them kind of figure it out on their own?
Well, I think a lot of stuff that the media portrays isn't quite accurate, per se, and I understand that, being in the position that I'm in. The only thing you can do, you know, and I've told plenty of guys, Ty Miles and a lot of guys who come into that role, all of a sudden people want to see what you're doing and react to it. You have to understand it. It's just part of the process. And know that what you're doing, you're going to talk about or want to write about, and magnify it. So, good or bad. I just think that sometimes maybe you can blow things out and blow them up a little bit and make them a little bit bigger deal. I think they're a great teaching tool for people who will use it. And, Dez and we're both are smart individuals. If you're around long enough, you know that this stuff just is more gossipy than it is football related.
Tony, Carson Palmer's going to be playing in this tournament too. Could you ever see, you've been a veteran, been around a lot, could you ever see yourself in a situation where you just got so frustrated that you just retire instead of retire or trade instead of
digging? Well, I just love, you know, for me, I don't know, I mean, that would be I just like playing the game. So, everyone has their own team, their own different issues and stuff, so for me, I've never had to feel that way, so.
Thanks,
Tony. Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate it.